The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins.
And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down.
Well, you don't turn your nose up at a gain of four, do you? They'll take that on first down. Playbook's got to be pretty well open on second and six.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. A first carry for Kenyon Drake. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
An early test. Two plays in. This is third and two. Now it's Jackson. That's caught. It's DeMarcus Robinson. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. It's a gain of 26 as they pick up the first down of the process.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Jackson's throw is on target to Duvernay. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 21. The Raven passing game getting in sync, another first down. They go play action with Jackson. Rolling to his right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive. But a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
Flushed out right. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. We know he's got the speed to get downfield, Charles, but there's the negative side. A little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field, and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you or closing in. All quarterbacks have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner.
Lance and the 49ers now, first and 10, at their own 13. Yellow, go. Following the fumble recovery, Lance, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Freeze up your guys elsewhere. With a tap forward on the jet sweep. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Lance to throw it. Man open, that's Debo Samuel. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Now Lance again. Again, he'll find Samuel for the completion. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. So in Raven territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 41. To throw, it's Lance. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again, or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
Here now is second and 10 again for the 41. Lance looking to throw it. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 29-yard line. Again, it's Lance. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there. Nearly an opening drive, INT.
And we're going to see this offense try and spread the field a little bit and utilize the outside third of the field, especially against man coverage. But that time, the defense was up to the task, forcing the incompletion.
Back to the air on second down. It's Lance. That's Samuel, caught left side. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 14. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Touchdown, 49ers! Trey Lance finding Deebo Samuel. And the 49ers use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Partner, are they going to cover him? That's four catches and the touchdown grab on that opening drive.
Well, what we're seeing so far, I believe, is their understanding that they want to go to him and often, but also they know they've got to move him around a little bit, get him.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. It's caught inside the five, and he gets in. And no one was expecting a fake there, but they add two more onto their lead. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he won't quite make it to the 25. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. One quarter down, 8-0 the score. From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. They go play action now, Jackson. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. It looked like they were trying to get him outside there, but this defense had different plans.
Yeah, they really had an outside-in kind of a pass rush. It's almost like when you're covering a punt. You can't let him get to the outside and get to the sideline. You force him to stay in the middle of the field, and they did exactly that and made the play.
And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And that'll be complete to Dobbins. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15.
That's where having a mobile quarterback really pays dividends, because that old school stand in the pocket, make your throw guy, he doesn't make that play.
In addition to the mobility, how about his eyes? Just kept them downfield, locked on the target, created a big play out of it.
Didn't matter the chaos around him, he still found his guy.
And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Give him 30 yards there. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Dobbins will score. Touchdown, Baltimore. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
A little surprising they wouldn't go for two, but this is up and good, and this is now a one-point game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
And now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. This one caught by Kittle. And they will get him down, but not before he gets very good yardage there, as that will lead us right into the two-minute warning. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Kittle, go! Red, cycle! Let's go,
charge! Lance now to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Again, they'll throw it with Lance. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 36. Now Lance. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And the Ravens are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Now, quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short.
I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. Room here to run. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 46 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball four times. Now Jackson on first down. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Throwing again on second down, Jackson. And he's going to go down here, a sack. They push him back to the 34. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. 49ers have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down. Jackson. Fine time, and the pressure gets to him again. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And they stake claim to the lead here. It's 10-8. So the defense able to force the interception, and the offense working their way into field goal range and able to get three out of it.
Yeah, and give them credit for that. They took the ball, maneuvered it downfield, and while they couldn't get exactly what they wanted, which was a touchdown, they did get 3 points out of it. So they paid off what the defense gave them. Both sides will be thrilled with that.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
He released that awkwardly. It almost looked like a pitcher who gripped his fastball a little too hard and let it go late, and it bounced in front of the plate.
Yeah, one of those fastballs that ends up at 57 feet, not 60 feet, 6 inches. Just a little short with the arm, which is unusual because we saw him in warm-ups. He's got a big, strong arm when he delivers it with confidence.
And Lance will try again on second down. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Ready, now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Lance going to throw. Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
Okay, great. Through 52.
They'll run for it. McCaffrey. And this is going to come up well short as they stop him on fourth down. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. We welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. The 49ers going to have the football and trailing on the scoreboard as we get back underway on EA Sports. Here's McLeod from his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
But Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Here's Lance. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk.
And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Lance going to try and throw on third down here.
And that is incomplete.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
Lance and company going on fourth down.
And able to haul it in is Kittle.
And he is going to have the Niners first down. No problem there. They get the first by 20 on fourth and inches.
I don't know about you, but I'm going to give them a little bit of credit for fortitude there. Fourth and inches, and they don't run the football. Normally, you just wedge your way through, fall forward, find the yardage. They took a shot and put in the air, and it paid off.
Maybe they saw the defense overcommitting?
A lot of confidence there, though, because even if they overcommit, you just want to make sure you get the first down. You throw an incompletion on fourth down there, they're going to second-guess you the rest of the game.
And this pass caught by Gray.
And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29.
Lance looks to throw again.
And his throw is incomplete.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well, and every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Throwing now is Lance.
Got his target, Samuel.
And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Lance now on first down.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
The defender certainly didn't forget about him leaking out of the backfield. There was a guy ready and waiting to pick him up in coverage, and that throw had no shot.
Third quarter of a two-point game, a good one so far. Here's second and 10.
And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Second and 10 here as we roll along in quarter number three from Santa Clara. Now Lance again.
And he will find his man Samuel. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 33. And he'll send the tight end in motion left. On first down, this is McCaffrey. Tackle made by Tyus Bowser.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Ready. Fight, kick.
On second and nine, Lance. And looking for Kittle, but it's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And the Ravens are going to get the football back at their own 17.
So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Oh, I saw this one with defensive eyes, because even as he escaped the pocket and bought time, the coverage stayed tight. Nothing broke down. Throwing it away, that was his only option.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 65 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now it's Jackson. And oh, he coughed it up. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. So turnovers, Charles, you figure will be key in the second half. And that's a big giveaway there.
Yeah, and as you and I both know, coaches are always preaching ball security. And none more often than right here in the second half of a tight football game. Now you've got to believe what the coaches are saying and take care of that football.
Following the fumble recovery, Lance over the middle, complete to Samuel. And he'll be brought down at the 27. Up the gut, McCaffrey. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Lance now on first down. He's going to drop this down to McCaffrey. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line. On second down, McCaffrey. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. So the scoring dried up here in the third. Nothing that quarter. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Here's Lance to throw it. And it's caught. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. McCaffrey running up the middle. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Christian McCaffrey taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Niners have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. The late turnover is so often the difference in a ball game. And here, the turnover leads to the go-ahead touchdown.
So repeat after me, partner. You have to take care of the football. In order to protect a lead, you must take care of the football. Ball security. How many times do they have to say it? They've been preaching it since day one of camp, and it came back to bite them right there.
And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So they're able to throw it in for the two-point conversion. Sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here, because if you do get it intercepted, it's returned by the defense. That's 2 points for them, but he identified an open target and put it right on him.
Taken at the 15, a short kick. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And now they'll look to answer, working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered, yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here. So just 3 yards on the completion there, and it'll be second down. Jackson from the shotgun. Eluded.
sending the pressure right.
That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end.
And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards.
They'll run up the gut with Dobbins.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carry before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
On second and nine, Jackson. And he lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers.
And that play just looked a little helter-skelter from the start, but that's the risk as a quarterback. Once you take off with that football, you might fumble it, and he did.
And he was going for the reward, which is gaining yardage, breaking down the defense. But you're right about the risk. Always lurking out there, someone always trying to get to the football. Try to find a place to cover up and slide and protect what you've earned.
Come on, set. Fight, six.
Out of the pistol, McCaffrey. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down.
To throw, it's Lance.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Lance looking to throw it. He finds Kittle going across the field.
He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Lance now to throw.
And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown.
Trey Lance finding Deebo Samuel. And the Niners get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter.
We talk so often about how hard it is to win in the NFL when you turn the ball over. And here a late turnover leads to a fourth quarter touchdown and a two-score lead.
And what's more important is being able to take advantage when a turnover presents itself. You've got to come up with points to make the other guy pay. They're able to do so here, and they've got a pretty good chance now of winning this football game.
And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away.
Taken at the 15, a short kick.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass, and finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass, and that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.